Hi guys, I'm Sumit Poddar and you're watching Play Chemistry. In this tutorial, we will discuss Dalton's atomic theory. Dalton's atomic theory has a great importance in the field of chemistry, as it was the first theory that explained the structure of matter. It explained the behavior of matter in terms of atoms and their properties. So let's get into it. Guys, before we start, we should know that Dalton's atomic theory consists of postulates. So let's Google what is postulate. Assume the fact, existence or truth of something as a basis of reasoning, discussion or belief. In fact, this theory is based on reasoning and studies, and he didn't have any experimental evidences to support these postulates. Postulate number one. All matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms. Atoms are indivisible and indestructible. Here we have image of graphite at an atomic level, obtained by a scanning tunneling microscope. The size of these atoms are in few nanometers. These atoms are so tiny that we need to magnify it about 1500 times to see. Dalton's model proposed that atoms are much like billiard balls. Both of them can't be created, divided or destroyed. They can simply be rearranged in different groups. But this analogy failed, since atoms are divisible and destructible. It is well known to us, the atoms have further subdivision, electrons, protons and neutrons. So yes, atoms can be divided. Another evidence that atoms can be divided and destroyed is transmutation. In transmutation, protons and neutrons are removed from the atoms or even added into it. So yes, we can destroy and convert it into an atom of another element. Removing three protons from lead atom converts it into gold. But to do so, we need a nuclear reaction. We can do such conversions with just chemical reactions. Postulate number two. All atoms of a given element are identical in mass and properties. It is generally seen that atoms of the same elements have same chemical and physical properties. But atoms of the same elements are not always alike. Now we know about isotopes. Isotopes are elements with same atomic number but with different atomic masses. According to Dalton's law, atoms of hydrogen should be similar, but different atoms of hydrogen can have different masses. Protium, deuterium and tritium are three isotopes of hydrogen with atomic masses 1, 2 and 3 respectively. So, atoms of the same elements can have different mass and properties. Another part of this postulate says, atoms of different elements have different mass and properties. An atom of sodium will be different from an atom of fluorine. An atom of hydrogen will be different from an atom of cobalt. According to this postulate, argon and calcium should be dissimilar, but their atoms have same atomic mass, 40 amu. Postulate number 3. Atoms of the same or different elements combine together to form molecules. And they do so in simple whole number ratio, such as 1:1, 1:3, 2:3. Like water, it is a combination of two hydrogens with one oxygen atom. It combines in a simple whole number ratio of 2:1. But there are some compounds like C12H22O11. It combines in a ratio of 12:22:11. So this ratio is not a simple whole number ratio always. Postulate number 4. Atoms of two elements may combine in different ratio to form more than one compound. Like when sulfur combines with oxygen, they form two different compounds, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. Postulate number 5. A chemical reaction is a rearrangement of atoms. Atom is the smallest particle that takes part in chemical reaction. In a chemical reaction, the whole atom reacts rather than a fraction of it. It means no electron, proton or neutron will be participating directly in a chemical combination. But protons take part in chemical reaction in upper atmosphere. Even photons that are massless participate in chemical reactions. Before we look at modern Dalton atomic theory, let's sum up Dalton's atomic theory. First, all matter is made up of atoms. Atoms are indivisible and indestructible. Point number two. All atoms of a given element are identical in mass and properties. Atoms of different elements have different mass and properties. Point number 3. Atoms of the same or different elements combine together to form molecules, and they do so in simple whole number ratio. Point number 4. Atom of two elements may combine in different ratio to form more than one compound. Point number 5, a chemical reaction is a rearrangement of atoms. Modern atomic theory. Point number 1, atom is no longer considered to be indivisible and indestructible. Point number 2, atom of the same element may have different atomic masses. Point number 3, atoms of the different element may have same atomic masses. Point number 4, the ratio in which different atoms combine with one another may be fixed and integral, but may not be always simple. Point number 5, atom is the smallest particle taking part in chemical reaction. Modern atomic theory still include this point, although we know that protons and photons take part in chemical reaction. I hope you learned something from this video. There are some relevant steps here. You can click to watch them or check the description down below. If you like this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and feel free to ask any question. Don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.